Today's project is inspired by American artist Keith Haring and his dancing figures, and we are using water-soluble oil pastels. So before we get into the project, let's talk a little bit about water-soluble oil pastels. So water-soluble oil pastels, these are portfolio brand, are really great because they work like regular oil pastels, but they also work like paint. So let's test out some of our colors to get a feel for the characteristics of this material. This is our blue oil pastel. And when we work with it dry, it looks just like regular oil pastel. But if we take a brush dipped in water and paint over that, the oil pastel blends out more like that. However, the way I like to use these is to actually take my water and dip just the tip into the water and use that directly with it wet. And this technique is the one we will be using for our project. Okay. So, some characteristics of Keith Haring's work that are important in making this project is that he used very bright colors a lot of the times. He used bold outlines, and he also used what I refer to as action lines around some of the figures so that when we're looking at them, we know that there's some energy or movement happening. So, to get started, I am going to select my color for my dancing and moving figure. So I'm going to actually use the yellow green. And my first dancing figure is going to have a circle for the head. A bit of a box or rectangle shape. For the body. And our arms are also going to use rectangle shapes. Bending at the elbow. And this is going to show us how our figure is moving. The same is true for the legs, except they will be bent at the knee. And then some feet and some hands. And that will be my first of my figures. The second figure, may actually appear upside down. This figure who's doing a handstand. And yet another figure. Keith Haring also made images of dogs. So there could be a barking dog figure. Next, before I get to the outline and the action lines, I'd like to add a background. So the background does take the longest amount of time because it has the most space, but I'm using the same technique. Okay, now that our background is done, we can go back in and add our outlines and our action lines. And that is our project inspired by the art of Keith Haring.